Students, this video is on different larval forms of the echinoderms. Okay, so today I'll discuss about the different larval forms of echinoderms. Basically, the echinoderms exhibit most complicated metamorphosis in the course of their indirect development. As we know from our general characteristic class, we came to know about that echinoderms has both direct and indirect mode of development. Okay, in direct type of development, there is no larval stages, but in case of indirect development, they exhibit the most complicated type of metamorphosis. Okay, in case of this echinoderm larva, they are bilaterally symmetrical, which marked the contrast to the radially symmetrical adults. Okay, so basically the larva are bilaterally symmetrical and the adults are radially symmetrical. Okay, the bilateral larvae undergoes metamorphosis in which the radial symmetry in adult is developed. So we will discuss the different larval forms in different classes of echinodermata. To begin with, we'll begin with first class Asteroidea. So in case of class Asteroidea, the larval form which is found is known as Bipinnaria larva. And the Brachiolaria larva. Okay, so we'll start with the Bipinnaria larva. These are free swimming larval form which developed cilia after hatching. Here in this diagram we can see these two structure. These two are the ciliated structure. Okay, the presence of powerful ciliated bands help in both feeding as well as in locomotion. Two lateral longitudinal locomotory ciliated bands developed, which connect in front of the mouth to form this preoral loop, and in case of anus, it forms the preanal loop. It is the same loop, the ciliated band forms the postoral loop in front. Okay, so which then the preoral loop then forms, it is a structure like this after invagination and evagination. Okay, and gradually this whole ciliated structure transforms into this type of structure with three lateral lobes. So basically this continuous longitudinal lobe invaginated and evaginated to form this lateral lobes. So just have a look, what are those? The anterodorsal, this one, then the posterodorsal, this one, and the posterolateral arm. So these three lateral lobes are in pair. So one pair of anterodorsal, one pair of posterodorsal, and one pair of posterolateral arms. Apart from that, they develop a post-oral arm here in front of that anus. Here is the mouth. Just after the mouth, they develop this arm. This is the post-oral arm. And so they basically have 5 pairs of arm. How it is? 3 is one pair anterodorsal, one pair posterodorsal, and one pair posterolateral, and one pair of posterooral, okay, and one pair of preoral arm. So this is known as the bipinnaria larva. The next one, that is the bipinnaria larva, transforms to form the brachiolaria larva, okay, which generally develop brachiolar arm at this point, that means at the apical region. Okay, so how it look like? The brachiolar arm comprises of 3 arms, just like this. Here, the 3 small arms are there. So it is look like this. So 2 lateral arms, these 2 lateral, and 1 median arm. 2 lateral and 1 median. At the base of this 3 arm, there lies a sucker, which is made up of glandular cells. Okay, the emergence of the sucker also mark the metamorphosis of this larva into the adult. Each of the arm, brachiolar arm, comprises of coelomic extension. As we can see, this is the coelomic finger-like extension. Okay, and there are adhesive cells that are present at the tip of each arm. Okay, these are the adhesive cells which are present at the tip of the arm. So this is the brachiolaria larva, and these 2 are found in case of the class Asteroidea. Next, we'll move to the next one, that is class Ophiuroidea. In the class Ophiuroidea, the larva that is found is known as the Pluteus larva. In case of Ophiuroid, it is known as Ophiopluteus larva. Ophiopluteus larva. Commonly known as the Pluteus larva, but in case of the Ophiuroidea, it is known as the Ophiopluteus larva. It is similar to that of Echinopluteus, another Pluteus larva that I will discuss later on. Okay, in this, the posterolateral arms are the longest and directed forward. Hopefully you remember from the previous diagram, the posterolateral arm. This one is the posterolateral arm. This is the posterolateral arm, which is the longest and directed forward. Okay, directed forwardly. The posterolateral arms are formed first. This is the first arm of Ophiopluteus. Then during the course of their development, they develop the anterolateral arm. Here you can see. Then the postoral, here it is, the postoral arm, the second, third arm, and the posterodorsal arm, that is the fourth arm. Okay, internally the larva comprises of cilome or the cilomic chamber in form of this two structure that is known as somatocilome or somatocoel. So at the both side they have, one is the left somatocoel and another one is the right somatocoel. Apart from somatocoel, they does have two other cilome that are known as the hydrocilome or hydrocoel. Both at two side, in the left it is known as the left hydrocoel and in the right it is known as the right hydrocoel. So in case of Ophiuroidea, the Ophiopluteus larva possesses basically four pair of arms. The first, second, third, I'm naming it as per its development, and the fourth arm. Okay. Next, I will move to the next class, that is class Echinoidea. The Echinoidea is the larval form found in the class Echinoidea is also known as the Pluteus. Pluteus larva. But it is Echinopluteus, Echinopluteus larva, which is basically different from that of Ophiopluteus larva in terms of two. One is the number of the arms and the other one is its shape. See, if you can see this one, in case of Echinopluteus, it is conical in shape. And apart from this forearm, they also possess two other arm. That is, one is anterodorsal and preoral. These two arms are not there in case of the Ophiopluteus. Okay, so so just have a look. These two are the preoral, these are the anterolateral, these are the postoral. Posterodorsal arm. Here they have the very ill developed posterolateral arm. Okay, in case of some Echinopluteus larva, the anterodorsal arm is absent. Fully grown larva, the anterodorsal and the posterolateral is also very ill developed. So in those cases they have only four pairs of arms. The tips of the each arm is provided with pigmented and calcareous calcareous skeletal rod. So each arm tip is pigmented. And supported with calcareous skeletal rod. Okay. Now they develop certain ciliated band. You can see this one, the pink color band. They develop certain ciliated band which basically helps in their locomotion, but the ciliated band in their case is known as epaulettes. Okay, as the ciliated band thickened, it forms a structure that is known as epaulettes. Okay, it helps in locomotion. So they have the posterior epaulettes and the anterior epaulettes, the thickened ciliated band. The fourth class is Holothuridea. In case of Holothuridea, we found two different types of larval form. One is Auricularia and the other one is Dolliolaria larva. Okay, the Auricularia larva are more similar to the Asteroid Bipinnaria larva. These are also free swimming larval form. Here, the ciliated band forms the preoral and the anal loop. The preoral loop, which probably you remember in case of this asteroids, here it is a preoral loop and the anal loop. So just like that, here also they have the preoral loop as well as the anal loop, which are guarded by the cilia, ciliary bands. Okay, the internally the larva has a carved gut and hydrocele. Here they have only one hydrocele and a pair of somatocele, the left somatocele and the right somatocele. As I have already discussed that these are the coelom apart from the archenteron. Okay, and the next one is the Dolliolaria larva. The Dolliolaria larva is the characteristic feature of the Holothuridea as well as the fifth class of the Echinoderm, that is the Crinoidea. Okay, so in case of Dolliolaria larva, it is barrel shaped. You can see it is of barrel shape with 4 to 5 ciliated band. Here I met in this diagram I have mentioned 4 ciliated band, 1, 2, 3, and 4. Here they have the apical sensory plate. You can see the sensory plate, which is provided with a tuft or bunch of cilia. Okay, these are known as the apical cilia. The metamorphosis is gradual. When it gradually acquires 5 tentacles and 1 to 2 functional podia. Podia I have discussed in the water vascular system. Podia are the locomotory organ or the feet, part of the 2 feet. So they acquire 5 tentacles, they are also known as pentactula. Okay, here it is, the pentactula. That means 5 tentacles. In case of the Crinoidea, they form stalk and referred to as pentacrinoid. Again, pentacrinoid. crinoid. In case of crinoidea, they are pentacrinoid. This larva metamorphose into the adult, the pentacrinoid larva. Hopefully you remember the structure of the crinoid, stalked body with this type of structure. So see, they develop five stalk as well, so they are known as the pentacrinoid. Okay, so this much for the larval, different larval forms of echinodermata. You can refer to R.L. Kotpal for this, for the significance. I will upload the next video. Okay.